Hello everyone, welcome to my channel again. And today I bring you a tutorial of automatic number plate recognition system. People used to call it ANPR, and this tutorial I have implemented in MATLAB. Before moving toward the main code, I am going to give you an overview of data set, because when it's come to machine learning and deep learning, data set is more important than the code part. So I'm opening my folder. First, for creating ANPR number system, automatic number plate recognition system, you require a binary image data set. This is the most simplest version of code. Your data set look like this. I have my own data set containing 75 images, and the size of each image is 42 by 24 in terms of pixels depth, and this is the binary image. Every number plate I'm having in my database containing uppercase letter, so I do not use lowercase binary images for recognition purpose. And talk about my data set, which I'm going to use for the prediction purpose, is containing, you know, something like 152 images. Every image is being captured in real world environment, and I had used real camera for capturing this number plates. As you can see here, the number plates are from Ontario, Canada. And let's move toward the main code part. So prior to move to the main code, I'm giving you the binary image you will have. You require to create a template database, which will be further at the end you will use for the comparison purpose, containing all the binary images. Here you can see I read every image from the database using imread. Once I read all the images, I also read numbers, letters. Finally, all the character I store in character array, converting every character array in a cell format and store in template. Once my all database is stored in template, my template look like this, containing image size 42 by 24 in UINT 8 format, and every image is binary image. Let's toward how we process the number plates. First, I grab the number plate. I can use any type of image format, JPG, BMP, GIF. Okay, in GIF image format, I will get the first frame. Once I read that image, as the image is being taken from real world environment, I have used discrete wavelet transform, two-dimensional for denoising purpose, and consider the upper band after being denoised. This function is available on our website, and the link is being given on discussion section of the video. Once my image being denoised, I locate the target of interest. As my camera intrinsic parameter remains same, so it's easy to identify where the number plate is being located. My number plate location is given here at this line. Then I perform the image resizing. Image resizing means the every image after cropping, I will actually drag that image into a fixed array so that I will not face any normalization issue. Once my image is being normalized, still the image is in RGB format. I need to convert that RGB format into grayscale using the function RGB to gray. Once my image is being converted into grayscale, my image will look like this. Let me show you, guys. Let's grab any image like this one. So as you can see here, my area, region of interest, is being cropped and image being converted into grayscale also denoised. After the converting grayscale, it's time to process the image using morphological operator and convert into a binary image, because it's important to convert that image into binary, as the template stores the binary character. So I have used, you know, traditional morphological operator, start from image filtering, winner filter, two dimensional, and filter size I have used is 4x4. Then a structure element, dilating, image dilation, image erosion, and after performing these operations, my image will look like this. Let me show you. Okay, now it's being more clear and number is clearly highlighted. Okay, then I perform the subtraction operation, then convert that gray scale that matrix into gray, converting double class, and after converting double class, I will apply brightness preserving function using convo2. Convolution is double image for brightening the edges, and then perform the intensity scaling on upon the image between 0 to 1, and will my output image will look like kind of binary now, and as you can see here, so every pixels which is being processed and converted into grayscale now binarized using IM adjust function, and edges also highlighted. Then convert that binarized image into logical image. After converting the logical image, my white portion will convert it to black and black will convert it to white. That means image being inverted. Then I further apply eroded operation and identify my region of interest. And after applying this part, my image will look like something like this. Okay. Once I completed these operation, it's time to identify the holes, like portions where the hole is being like O, like A, holes being filled using IM fill operation. Then apply image thinning, and after applying image thinning, I again apply image erosion operation. You know, these set of parameter actually I identify after a lots of trial and tested, and made them set so that it will capable to perform the required operation for me. Once everything is done, it's time to figure out where my number is being placed. And for doing these things, there is a built-in function controlling is available. It determines the array indices of bounding boxes of interest, and in return it will basically give us the total number of identified characters available in the image. Let me show you the output of controlling. It basically map it, as you can see here, the output of controlling is 6 7 10 15 16 20. So it give us a length of array where a number can be possibly placed, and the prop consists the bounding boxes. Let me show you this part to help you to understand the little architecture. Okay, eye drops consist, you know, this much number of logical outputs and tier location of bounding boxes. So uh, it highlighted those areas where the possibly number can be placed. And as you can see here, there are 23 possible outlines where you can actually segment the whole image. So it's concatenate iProp bounding boxes and applying the controlling function, it actually returns the total region of interest in numerical format, that 6, 7, 10, 13, 15, 16 and 20 can be possibly the place where our number, like number plate, number region of interest located. After the region of interest is being located, iProps.image will take out the image portion, and once the iProp image being take out the image portion, it's time to open a read letter function. What it read letter do, it actually load the our previous save template and take the snap of that cropped eye portion. I can show you that small portion for one iteration. Let me make a pause here and I'll interrupt the operation after that. So it's showing the press any key, that means pause is being arrived. And let's see what is the first dimension look like. My image consists in a capital I containing logical arrays. And once my logical array is being fed to corresponding RV, my image will look like something this, where V is stand for 1 and contain the image, and I'll show you the output capital N and like this. This is first binary output, and our original image was I'm sure. So I'll open that image in another. So as you can see here, guys, this is the first output. It look like B. It basically, that's how the controlling function actually works. It isolate the first output, first letter from this image, and that's the B. And this letter is fed to our read letter function. Now the read letter function take that letter as an input, reshape it to the template size. Once it being reshaped into template size, and template is being loaded, a cross correlation function, two dimensional correlation coefficient comes into existence, and once it come into existence, it basically produce an score corresponding to each array. I'm going to show you how this thing actually done. So inside that function, closing, so n is my snap. So I need to go up and instead of snap I need to write here n, and what you will guys see, an output of com containing a score associated with every template, and maximum of that score will yield us a letter. And as you can see here, the fourth one is actually showing the maximum score, the 45th, let me calculate the maximum, let me see which one is the, what is the maximum of that, COMP, my maximum is 8.91, and let's see what is the index value. And so as you can see, it is being placed at 57th position, something like here. And let's see what is actually containing the template at 57th position. This one. So you need to call that one. So target will equal to template, and it is at 57th position. So target, and then I'll show. Target. Sorry. Let's see what is the image. As you can see here, my target also the binary, binary B. So that's how actually it's work. And once this read letter, it process that output, and we'll see the maximum occur where. And you can see here, if VD is equal to 3, 4, 57, 60, 63, 18, then outcome is letter B. There else at LC, something like that. So let's run this entire program, and we'll see what output will look like on the same image. And I need to remove pause from this point. Okay, I need to select, let's say I'm selecting this image. And as you can, guys, you can see here, this give me exactly the same output containing the number plate in the form of TXT BVJL383. So this is all about the number plate ANPR, automatic number plate recognition system. I hope you guys understand how this works. I have also created an automated version in MATLAB, where you can take an entire folder and create an TXT file from that folder. It keeps on running after taking a pause of 4 seconds, 3 seconds. And this is all about today. You get the list of functions on the discussion section of the video, and the corresponding links will be available on our website. Thanks for watching the video. If you guys looking for the entire solution of this source code, so just contact me. I have given my contact number at the title section of the video. This is all about today. Thanks for watching this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and subscribe and share, so that others can also learn, data science and upcoming things in here. Bye bye, guys.